1, I'm going to select. I'll be using today the Apostles' Creed. That is a nice one. I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of the saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. God is our Creator and Father, made Himself visible to us in His Son. Through His Spirit, He loves us and wants us to make Jesus known and loved. So therefore, let us pray.
Lord our God, hear our prayer. Father, Creator of heaven and earth, help us to respect Your creation, to develop this world, and to make this earth fruitful for the benefit of all people, we pray.
Lord our God, hear our prayer.
Help us to grow more like Jesus and to continue on earth His task of bringing salvation and freedom to all, we pray.
Lord our God, hear our prayer.
Help us through the Spirit to heal what is wounded, to soften what is hard, and to warm what is cold, we pray.
Lord our God, hear our prayer.
Father, Son, and Spirit, let this community and Your whole church become a living sign to this world of Your own community of love, we pray.
Lord our God, hear our prayer.
May those who are afflicted with addictions turn their will and their lives over to the care of God as they understand Him, we pray.
Lord our God, hear our prayer.
What other intentions should we bring to our triune God today?
For all fathers living and deceased, as we celebrate Father's Day, that they will and have always been examples to us of St. Joseph and of your Father that we love. May you give them eternal rest and give them hope for the future as they help their young ones, we pray.
Lord our God, hear our prayer.
Lord our God, be the foundation and meaning of our Christian lives, and lead your pilgrim people to the fullness of your life and love, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we get ready for the off-prayer session, I just want to remind you, it's not like I'm rushing today. It's just that the wedding, people coming in, the wedding of my father, I'm trying to be cognizant of us not rushing for cleanup and everything, because they're coming in about 11:45. So, as long as we're out by then. Thank you.
above all creation, for your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And the Lord accept that sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and all.
O God and Father, we bring this bread and wine before you as the fruits of your kindness and of our toil. Let your Holy Spirit fill them with this power to make your Son, Jesus Christ, present here among us, that we may share in Jesus' offering, and that through Christ, with him and in him, we may give you all honor and praise, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. We joyfully proclaim our faith in the mystery of your Godhead. You have revealed your glory as the glory also of your Son and of the Holy Spirit. Three persons equal in majesty, undivided in splendor, yet one Lord, one God, ever to be adored in your everlasting glory. And so with the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory as we sing their unending hymn of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power, God of might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, the death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this all of you and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
In memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life-giving bread, the saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share the body and the blood of Christ be brought together with the unity by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church throughout the world, make us grow in love, together with our bishops, Lionel and Terry, with Pope Benedict, with all those who serve you in your churches. Remember our brothers and sisters who have died and gone to their rest in the hope of rising again, especially any deceased fathers that we remember in our hearts today. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, Saint Joseph, the foster father of Jesus, with the apostles, with Saint Dorothy and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son.
Forever.